My name is Utkarsh, and I'm offended, right? Finally, I am. Actually, I've heard this word dumb and unintelligent and these things far too many times in debates such as this. Would the panel please define what a dumb young person is, right? Let me complete my question. The second thing is, once you define that, then you also please define an order of intelligence which is considered intelligible enough to have an opinion. That's the first part of my question. It was sedition was also a part of today's debate, right? Would the panel please enlighten me that the idea of India versus the state of India, where does the difference actually lie? And if the state of India is going forward because of the demographic framework or democratic framework, then isn't it actually the state a byproduct of the people? So are we essentially trying to create silos within already created silos? If yes, why? And the third part of my question is to all of you. How many of you have read Satanic Verses? How many of you have read Satanic Verses? Four people. How many of you oppose the idea of Salman Rushdie being treated the way he was because he wrote Satanic Verses? How many of you have actually read Satanic Verses? But do you oppose that a writer should be treated the way he or she was? Because you've, or should that stop you, the idea that you've not read a book, should that be reason enough to stop you from expressing an opinion? No. And that is the idea of representational politics, that you don't need to be, I mean, what I hear is actually, Ambedkar wrote a very interesting paper on constitutional morality, which was on the rule of law versus the rule of numbers. And not just in this panel, I'm extremely offended by the idea, which is redolent of Plato's Republic, that you need to be a certain someone in order to have an opinion which is considered worth an opinion. Now here, are we trying to create a debate between constitutional morality, the rule of law, rule of numbers, and the rule of intellectuals, however we define that? If yes, why? Is my question.
You should also specify who exactly you are asking this question to, because I see Mr. Mihir has given up. The moderator is too polite, and he is too much of a gentleman. So you should ask him directly.
Simply put, sedition is, especially given what the nature of the Indian state is, sedition is an invented crime to ensure that opinions that are difficult to the state can be at any time or place be clamped down on. That has always been the case with sedition. The Indian state, because it is particularly pluralistic in conception, sedition should be an even more meaningless crime here than otherwise. And yet we have it on the books. We have, people are locked up I don't have a list, but there's a lovely list on Kafila of people who have been locked up for sedition doing various different, criticizing companies in Chhattisgarh, criticizing Mr. Modi in Gujarat, and criticizing the government in UP, in, you know, whatever. It's across the political spectrum. Sedition has been used as a method of political control. And that is actually what sedition is. I mean, there is no, how can I badmouth the conception of India? I mean, anyone who says Nehru was an idiot or didn't understand that India was religious is somebody badmouthing the conception of India and the conception of the Indian state and is committing sedition. But why are you not prosecuting that? No, because you'll prosecute only the people you want to. So sedition is a meaningless crime, and we have it on the books, God knows why. All right, about the question of the youth and stupidity, which I know there's no answer to, I think that one valid point about how to define stupidity is, the only valid answer to how to define stupidity is like that, I've forgotten which Supreme Court judge in the US said about pornography. I'm not sure I can define it, but I know it when I see it. So yes, I know stupidity when I see it, but I can't define it to start off with. No, absolutely. I mean, youth is entitled to think that other people are stupid, but, you know, and as a member, I think a lot of people, regardless of age, are stupid. The question of whether or not you need to have rights or qualifications in order to speak, you don't. But there's a big difference between that and representation. If you say, I am going to be speaking about something complicated, and I know it is complicated, in order for everybody else to take you seriously, it should be the case that you should be able to explain how you understand those complications. That's it. And in fact, we have a that's not actually the problem in our country that much. We have a problem of not being able to understand what qualifies people. So if someone thinks that Mr. Sridharan built a metro, so he can talk about everything. All right, he can probably talk about public transport, and probably not all public transport, just metros. All right, because he's shown his ability there. We should take him very seriously when he talks about that. On the other hand, when he talks about political parties, whatever else he's talked about in the past, I don't see any reason why I should take him seriously. All right, ditto for a bunch of you know, even on the social on social media, on the back of books that you read, it's like so and so went to IIT, IIM, and therefore here's his novel. All right, you know, I am an engineer or whatever, and therefore take my opinion on the Lokpal seriously. This is all ridiculous.
Thank you for writing off the panel almost entirely. Politeness is not one of the virtues that we treasure, though, but it's a very important point. And Utkarsh, you've almost pushed us out of the comfort zone, not that we were planning to stay there for long, but it's an important point. And you know, there's always this disclaimer at the end of most articles that you read in the papers. The organization and the paper does not necessarily endorse the opinion of the commentator. There are many voices and there are many things that have been said today. The idea is to provoke discussion and the idea is to get to ask more questions. Sedition, though, is something that warrants a longer, more extensive discussion, because what has happened across the country is not something that is simple and easy to answer. There have been very, very different lines at which people have been booked. The nature of the crimes for which they're booked under sedition have been as diverse as we pointed out. Just carrying a single book of a certain nature of publication by something, and who's interpreted whether it was anti-national, whether it was meant to overthrow the Indian national state, a bunch of policemen who've probably never even read the book. And as far as stupidity in the youth are concerned, well, I'm a teacher. And I teach a class full of 30 students. And there is nobody who I would say is at the same intellectual level as one or the other. But we celebrate diversity. What Hindul, and I'll hand the mic over to him in just a short while, what he was probably trying to attribute is the idea that I have 500 people behind me and therefore I need to be taken seriously and therefore I need to have the right to comment on a certain issue. Nothing against stupidity. Like I said earlier, the more voices that you have, and you have to flood people with voices. You can only counter discourse with more discourse. And everybody has the right to be heard. And that is something that no one's denying here. Hindul.
Thank you very much. Stupidity, yes, of course. What we have in India today is mobocracy. And that is a very scary thing. And I shall defend to death my right to stand against mobocracy. This idea that everybody, just on the basis of numbers, is justified in propelling a point of view. It's what happening with Baba Ramdev. Baba Ramdev has no business, and I will say it again and again, has no business doing what he is doing. He's disrupting public life. He has a vested agenda. He himself is far from clean, but yet he's able to hold the capital of this country to ransom because he can draw thousands of people, and most of those thousands of people, I was at the Anna Hazare movement and its campaigns day after day. Most people there didn't even know what were the nuances of the Lokpal bill. And that sort of ignorance is not just, it's not just wrong in a country like India, and at this point of our history, it is fatally wrong. And if we support this kind of ignorance just on the power of numbers, on this great idea that everybody is able to do anything because we're a democracy, then we do disservice to our idea and where this country should be. This is a, you know, this justification, and I will always stand against this justification. You cannot justify complex ideas need complex responses. And for you to understand those complex ideas and therefore validate a response takes time. As Mihir was saying, Mr. Sridharan can speak on public infrastructure. He has given 40 years of his life into public infrastructure. Tomorrow, if Mr. Sridharan comes and tells us what we should do about the nuclear program of this country, his opinion is not valid. But in this country, we have two extremes. We deify people. Because Baba Ramdev is a yoga guru and thousands of people watch him on TV, people will come out on the streets for them. He's God. That's the problem. But he's not. He has no basis
for saying anything that he's saying on the political structures of this country. He has no understanding of the political structures of this country. And if you support a Baba Ramdev, then you do disservice to the idea of India and you do disservice to the idea of democracy. Democracy doesn't mean that you support the lowest common denominator. In India, often it's become the lowest common denominator. It's almost like in America, why people support a George W. Bush. You know, oh, it's too intellectual to understand the liberals, so therefore, you know, here's a guy who's like us, let's just vote for him. That's ridiculous. We are a complex nation. We have complex problems. Those complex problems require complex responses. Please have the heart and definitely the space in your life to please formulate those complex responses. That's all I'm talking about.